This video is set up for the technician that wants to repair slash overhaul a Hermle 451-050 movement. There are other 451 movements out there made by Hermle, with the last three letters being different, and they're very similar to this one. It's just some of the way the chime rods are coming off the movement, whether they're bottom chime rods on the side or coming out the back. But essentially,
next the movement the is a Hermle movement, chain-driven grandfather clock. This movement happens to be a dud movement. Not sure what's wrong with it. Got it out of my dud drawer. And we'll see what's wrong with it. All three chains are exactly the same. Same length, same gauge, same lengths per inch. So as long as your chains are in good shape and you don't have any deformed links, sometimes they become deformed or they start to open up. If they start to open up, it could be because the customer had yanked on the weight itself, which would put even stress on all the links, and they all open up a little bit. So make sure that all of the links are nice and closed like this one is. Okay. And let's see if these are steel links. Let me see if I got a magnet here. Yep, these are regular steel links, and they're brass plated, which would explain as they get older and older, they start to look silver instead of brass, as the brass coating is starting to wear off. One side of the chains is, let me adjust the mirror here, is a loop, and the loop always goes towards the weight, and then you got the pull side over here. Kind of self-explanatory, just make sure that you put the chain in correctly, and that when you pull on this one, that the great wheel rotates. Okay, so see the rotation of this guy? That would mean that the pull side is coming off of this side right here. Make sure you got that. Otherwise, you're going to have to take everything all apart again. But for right now, we'll just get rid of the chains.